Hi, today I'm going to be talking about controlling a Linux CNC machine with a USB controller. I found a lot of examples on the internet where people are doing this, but in order to get it set up, it's very difficult. I found an easy way to do it with a program called Qjoypad, and I want to show you guys how I did it. So first I want to show you what we're trying to accomplish, then I'm going to show you how it's done. So if you look over here, we have a CNC machine. This is the TIAG CNC machine. We have a Linux CNC computer set up, and it's all set up and ready to go. We can control it with the keys, but I really wanted to have something that was more user-friendly and a little bit easier to use with one hand or with the other hand. So what I did is I found this USB controller, and this is what I'm going to use to control the CNC machine. So if you take a look, I have the different functions mapped. So I have my up, down, left, right, my X and my Y axes, and I have my Z axes mapped to these buttons. I have my speed mapped to speed slower on the left bumper and speed quicker on the right bumper. So if you take a look at the CNC machine, I can move it with the Y axis, you can move the X axis, and I can also move the Z axis. If I want to increment the speed or decrement the speed, I can use these buttons. So if I want to go slower, slow it down. If I want to go faster, so that's what we're trying to accomplish. Let me show you how I did it. Okay, so what I did is plugged in my USB controller, and now what I'm going to do is install Qjoypad. So there's a couple different methods of installation. You can download the source code and compile it, but I find that is a little bit more difficult than other methods. So I'm going to show you how I do it. I actually install it through a Debian package file, which you can download off the internet and then double click to install. So I'm going to open up my web browser. And then I found a repository that has the file that we're looking for. And the way that I find it is I do a quick Google search, and the user is falktx, and then I include the name of the package, which is Qjoypad. And then I'm using version 4.1. So you get a list of some different packages. Depending on your system, you might use one or the other. I'm just going to go ahead and use this i386 version. So I'm going to click on it. If you scroll down, you'll find under built files, there's a package that ends in .deb. This is the installer that we're looking for. I just click it, download it. I'm going to go ahead and save the file, and I'm going to launch it. So I see that there's an issue telling me it's going to require the installation of one package. So it's telling me I need to install libqtgui4. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and install that. So I'm going to close this. Move this over here. So the way you're going to have to do that is by a simple command. It's sudo apt get install, and then it's going to be the package that we're missing, which is libqtgui4. So it's going to ask if you want to install it. Just verify with yes. If you're having an error when you try to do that, make sure that you run sudo apt get update. And then what that'll do is update your package manager to make sure that you have access to the latest package. So now I'm going to try to run the installer again and see what happens. Okay, all dependencies are satisfied. Let's go ahead and install the package. If you run into any other problems, there are some other packages which you may have to install. I didn't have to, but I'll go ahead and list those on the screen. So if you need to, you can have those available. But I'm going to install. It's going to ask you for your password. I'm using the default, which is LinuxCNC. So what that's going to do is go ahead and install the Qjoypad program. Okay, good. Installation's finished. Let's close this out. And let's go ahead and open the program. So we're going to go to our applications. And for some reason it puts it under games, but I'm not going to worry too much about that. And then I'm just going to open it up. And what it does is opens... It's a little hard to see, but it's up in this system tray. You're going to have to click on that, and it's going to bring up a window that basically shows all your key mappings. And what you're going to do next is you're just going to do come down here to Quick Set, and then it's just going to ask you the name of the button that you want to use. So if you take a look down here, what I can do is I can map any of these buttons. So I can map my axes, or I can map my buttons. I just need to click on it in order to let it know which one I want to use. So, for example, I'm going to map the left arrow. And it's going to ask me for a key, so I'm going to push the key on my keyboard. I'm going to go ahead and do the same with the down, with the right, the up, and then I'm going to do my Z-axis and my speed control. And what you want to do is make sure you update that and save it, and then I'm just going to close this out. The software stays open, and now I can open my CNC machine, and let's see if the buttons map properly. So I'm going to go ahead and enable my machine, and then I'm going to try it out. Looks like it's working, and that's how you map your CNC machine to a USB gamepad. Hope you guys found this helpful. Leave me some comments if you have any questions.